Welcome back. Oil and OMOs have helped the Indian markets outperform the rest of the region in the last few trading sessions. In fact, for this year itself, while the Nifty may have not given you too much return, so just up close to about 3% in 2018, if you compare that with the rest of the Asian markets, where the Chinese markets are down more than 20%, Korean markets have fallen about 15-16%, there is that clear outperformance. Is that trend going to continue into 2019? What sector should you bet on? Anand Tandon, the market expert, joins in to talk about the market fundamentals. Anand, that's the first question. Do you think Indian outperformance will continue? And 2018 has not given too much return per se from an index point of view. What should we expect in 2019?
Well, I think, you know, on the one hand, we have a somewhat of a slower global outlook than it was, let's say, even a few weeks ago. And that will mean that there will be a greater flow from perhaps the developed markets into emerging markets. That should sustain a little bit, except that yesterday's Fed move kind of negated that a little bit. On the domestic side, you know, the issue will be that we will have a little better liquidity as well as perhaps a more softer interest rate outlook for the next few months, at least going into the election. Given where we are in terms of the valuation, that only means that you are still looking at earnings growth being the major driver. And for now, it appears that the earnings growth is shifting to what one would call the dog sectors, which is essentially the public sector banks and perhaps the industrials. So the logical positioning would be that these are the two sectors which have not performed very well over the last few many quarters, and where there is now signs that they may have already troughed out and are moving up, and where the valuations are also not factoring in the kind of upside. So largely on the domestic side, industrials and corporate-facing banks, and otherwise those which will benefit from a slightly weaker rupee, which is likely to sustain for a while.
Mm-hmm. Anand, hi, good to see you in today. What about the mid-caps? Because while we've seen some amount of recovery for the mid-caps, it's been a stark underperformance on a year-to-date basis as compared to the Nifty Sensex. Your sense in terms of what we could see in 2019, and do you think it's just going to continue to be a stock picker's market?
Well, it's always easy to say that it will be a stock picker's market because that's a truism. The reality is that, you know, unless there is enough liquidity available in the market, mid-caps don't perform. And you can go back and look at it anytime, irrespective of the valuations. When liquidity is high, the performance of mid-caps is superlative, perhaps even higher than that of the large cap, and vice versa. As I said, my basic assumption is that for the next 6 months at least, we will be moving into a slightly easier liquidity scenario. And I would therefore imagine that relative to the large caps, the mid caps will not do badly. In fact, they might also do better. Also, as you pointed out, because of the fact that many of them have corrected very sharply, the valuation problem that was there earlier in the year has now vanished. And to a large extent, you can find quality companies which are, you know, not only cheaper, but have a slightly better earnings trajectory and are being supported by the liquidity. Overall, I would argue that it is definitely, pro mid cap and small cap. And the large caps, by and large, do not have too much upside except for a few sectors, as I pointed out, because they are already priced to perfection and kind of factoring in very high earnings growth, which again, to my mind, is somewhat suspicious.
Okay, we've already had 6 years of an earnings down, 6 years when we've seen earnings getting downgraded through the course. Let's hope it doesn't happen next year. But as you said, the expectations are quite high even for next year. Anand, there is talk about, additional bank recapitalization, which could come through today, which could trigger some banks out of the PSU list. How do you approach PSU banks now? Because they've put in a pretty big rally in the last few days.
By and large, you know, anything with public sector is not aligned with your interests. Now, that said, the public sector banks will certainly do well if they are capitalized because they now have money to go out and lend, which was sorely lacking. The fundamental issue remains that there has been nothing changed in the way they will lend. So they will again go out and build new NPAs. But that's a 10-year cycle. So we'll come to that problem later on. For the near term, what you're likely to see is the banks which do have growth capital, not just enough to fill the hole they are in, but to actually go out and lend and grow their balance sheet again, will go out and do that. And therefore, the earnings, at least in the near term, will look up. And that will probably justify the market going out and putting some buys on that. However, from a longer-term perspective, I think probably the only public sector bank that I would think is worth buying is State Bank of India. And for the others, you're probably better off looking at the private corporate-facing banks.
Mm-hmm. It's been a great year, Anand, for a couple of these consumption stocks. Britannia up 36% year to date. Pidilite has gone up around 34%. And the view is that, you know, consumption is going to be probably one of the big themes to watch out for as well going into 2019. Would you buy more of these stocks? What would your recommendation be?
Well, from a portfolio's perspective, consumption has been the only theme that has been working. And therefore, as I pointed out, many of these are priced to perfection and then some more. Therefore, you know, do you want to be overweight this sector now? I would argue not really. Would you move out of them completely? Obviously not. So, you know, I would argue that it's time now for being somewhat underweight consumption. And that includes all the names that you mentioned. Obviously, they will put up the same level of growth, but the kind of delta that you're likely to see in earnings is probably going to be higher if you're looking at the sectors I mentioned, including industrials and perhaps the corporate-facing banks.
Okay. Thank you, Anand, for your time. Maybe it's time to go underway the consumption story, though it's done very well, and time to load up on industrials as well as corporate-facing banks. That's the word coming in from him. Get into a break. Up next, we focus on how the global setup is looking. Stay tuned for that.